Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial for the Syncfusion Blazor Progress Button. In general, the Progress Button is used to show the progressing state of the button action. Look at this download button, the progress percent is shown in the button, which lets you estimate how long the completion of the button action will take. In this video, I will show you how to add the Blazor Progress Button component to your app with its built-in features such as support for icons, different spinner positions, and how to animate the button content and the Progress Button spinner. To explore the other features available in Syncfusion Blazor Progress Button, refer to the website link shown in the above YouTube card. I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For this, I need to make sure the .NET Core SDK's latest version is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio 2019, or Visual Studio 2022 installed. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app. So, let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Blazor Button, and click the Next button. After that, I click the Create button with the default target framework, to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps, and how to add Syncfusion components to one, then, you can click on the video link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, let's add the Blazor Progress Button component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Split Buttons NuGet package in the application. I open the NuGet Package Manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Split Buttons in the Browse tab and install the package in my project. Once the installation is completed, I navigate to the Imports Razor file, and here, I add the Syncfusion Blazor Split Buttons namespace. Now, I can start using the Blazor Progress Button component in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method @SyncfusionBlazor within this main method. I should also register a valid license key in my application. So, let me register a trial license key using the registerLicense method. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor Progress button. I navigate to the index.html file to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now everything is configured, so let me add the Blazor Progress button component. First, I need to open the index.razor file, remove the default code, and include the Progress button component. Then, I need to add content for the progress button, so, within this code section, I define the variable button content and assign the value download to it. Now, I will assign this variable button content to the content property of the progress button. Now, I am going to run this example. So here, you can see in the output page, the progress button component is rendered. And if I click the button, the spinner is shown. If I want to change the button type as primary, then I need to define the property as primary and set its value as true. Along with this, I am going to display a progress button at the center of the output page, so I will add a division section here and define custom style for it. Looking at the output page, the primary progress button type is filled with a blue background color. Here, while clicking the button, the spinner is positioned at left side of the text content. Suppose, I would like to change the spinner position either at right, top, or bottom, then, I need to make use of the position property. To change the spinner position, first I need to define the progress button spin settings tag within this progress button code. Then, I will define the property position and set its spin position to right. I want to set a custom width for the spinner too, so, let me define the property width with a custom value. Now, when I click the progress button, the spinner is positioned on the right side of the text content with the custom width. Next, I will show you how to set custom styles for the spinner using the template property. To apply a custom style for the spinner, I need to define the property spin template and add a division element with a class attribute. Now, I am going to define a few CSS styles for this template class. Then, I define an animation effect for the template class using the @keyframes property. So, when I click the progress button, the custom spinner is shown with the animation effect. Now, let me show you how to apply animation to the progress button content. First, I need to define the progress button animation settings tag within this progress button code. Then, I will define the property effect inside the progress button animation settings section. The Blazor progress button supports 7 different effects. I am going to slide the button content up while clicking the button, so I will set the effect to slide up. To set custom duration and timing function, I will need to define the properties duration and easing with appropriate values. Looking at the output page now, when I click the progress button, the content moves upward of the button. Now, I will show you how to set an icon in this download button. To add icons, I define the property icon CSS and set appropriate class names to it. Within this style section, I define a font face with a specific SRC path and name the font family button icons to start accessing the download font icon at the application level. Then, to this class name assigned to the icons property, I will now assign the appropriate content value to access the download font icon. See the progress button now displayed with the download icon. By default, the icon is positioned to the left side of the progress button. If you would like to customize the icon's position, then you can use the icon position property. I am going to place the icon at right side of the button content, so I will define the property icon position and set its position as right. Looking at the output page now, the icon is placed at right side of the button content. Finally, I will show you how to change the button content during the progress state. I am going to retain the properties content, icon, and icon position, and remove all other properties from the progress button code for better clarity. Here, I want to show the downloading progress in the button, so I will hide the spinner by setting this eHideSpinner class to the CSS class property. Then, I will define enableProgress property with the value true to show progress state in the progress button. To change the button content during the progress state, I will define progress button events first and added the event onBegin with the appropriate event handler. Then, I define the event handler begin, and it receives the argument of type progress event args. As I said before, I am going to change the button content during the progress state, so within this begin method, I set the content property value to downloading for the button content variable. So now, when I click the progress button, the button content changes to downloading. If I would like to change the button content text to download after the progress completion, then I can use the event onEnd. I have the onEnd event here with the appropriate event handler. Then, I define the event handler ends, which receives the argument of type progress event args. To change the content after progress completion, I will set the button content to download within this ends method. Look at the progress button now. When I click the button, after completing the progress, the button content changes to download. Now, let me quickly recap what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor progress button component in a WebAssembly app. We have seen how to set icons and different spinner positions and how to add events to the progress button component. Finally, we have seen how to animate the button content and the progress button spinner. If you would like to see the working example from this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.